Hey, what's up, and welcome back to Interpreting the Scares. Today, we're rounding it back to the king of found footage with Paranormal Activity 4. Even if you're a hardcore fan of the series, like I often claim to be, this is one of the tougher movies to get through just because it's just so far away from where the series began. For some people, it works, but I think for most, it just can't, because the further it went from that first film, the more complicated it also got, which also means a whole heck of a lot more plot holes at the same time. The craziest thing is, the series hasn't even gotten a fraction of the weirdness it will get soon enough. So if you insist on watching the sequels, then I gotta say, try to at least keep to the first trilogy and that's it. Leave it there. That's your best bet. For now, I'll try to make sure to forfend you from watching the rest of the series. Let's get cracking. This review is brought to you by the word of the day, forfend, avert, keep away, or prevent. Paranormal Activity 4 focuses on a brand new family this time around. When the woman next door falls ill and is transferred to a hospital, the Nelson family agrees to look after her young son until she returns. Unbeknownst to them, this young boy, Robbie, is very weird and seems to have brought an evil entity to their home. This movie's all over the frickin' place and littered with plot holes that don't make sense, nor are ever explained, but before I talk about some of the things that bothered me, I want to first say that, as usual, I liked how they were willing to change a few things up. The utilization of the infrared Xbox Kinect sensors for paranormal discovery, that was awesome. It was awesome. I think I've actually seen ghost hunting shows use the same idea in certain episodes. It looks really cool in general, and as an audience member, you're not fully sure where to look because there's thousands of these little dots all over the screen, and if maybe one moves where it's not supposed to, you might miss it. That was awesome. They also included Skype as one of the ways that they filmed for found footage, and that's somewhat interesting. This actually has to be one of the earlier variations of desktop horror mixed with, you know, standard found footage stuff. Skype isn't a bad idea. I mean, it's modern, it's relatable. But you know what? That's it. That's all the positives that I have to say about this movie. The rest is just hogwash. This is the first film in the series, I feel like, that didn't even try or attempt to explain why these people are filming things in the first place. They just are. The third film also had some issues surrounding that, but it did have a foundation. The man in Paranormal Activity 3 filmed and edited weddings for a living, and when he started witnessing the weird stuff going around his house, he filmed it. Now, it was mostly a bit of a stretch, but it did make at least a fraction of sense, while this did not. I've seen this fourth movie a few times now, I've reviewed it twice before, and my score just keeps getting lower and lower because I just keep noticing more and more annoying faults that it has. I don't usually talk about spoilers in my reviews, but I have to right now. I have to, because it's a major reason why I feel the way that I do about this movie. So if you do not want to be spoiled, skip ahead to my score. If you don't care, carry on. One of the biggest things about this movie is this weird kid, Robbie. As the film begins, it reminds you that Katie kidnapped her nephew, Hunter, in Paranormal Activity 2. The two of them have not been heard of since. You know, this kid, Robbie, lives with his single mother across the street, and there's a giant mystery surrounding him, so you can easily assume that he is Hunter, but there's also the chance that he's not, because he doesn't really look like Hunter. He's got the wrong hair, he got the... I don't know. You have to ask yourself, if Robbie isn't Hunter, then who is he? And why would Katie kidnap somebody else entirely when the coven's drive was to kidnap the firstborn in the family, who was Hunter, who she already successfully kidnapped in the second film? And if he's not Hunter, then how does she lose him in the first place? That's the spoiler. This kid is not Hunter. He's just Robbie. And once you figure that out, Robbie disappears, never to be heard of again. Who the frickin' crap was Robbie? And where's Hunter? Oh, that's right. He's the kid in this main family here who was adopted. They legally changed his name to Wyatt. Surprise! So that's interesting to know that there was a legal battle between demon and human in order for an adoption to take place. None of this is explained. Nobody explained how Hunter went from being kidnapped to adopted by a completely random family. In general, I find this movie to be boring. Every scare is predictable, even the fakeouts. You know when they're trying to fake you out. It's ridiculous. The movie as a whole is ridiculous. Thankfully, it doesn't dive too deeply into the coven story, and it just tried to stay more grounded, I think, than the third movie, or honestly, the next couple of films in the franchise. And like I said, I like some of the technical choices made in this film, like the Kinect sensors, but this is mostly a movie that I strive to stay away from. Let's talk about my end score for a second. From a technical, unbiased perspective, I think this movie is business as usual, and most importantly, safe. It constantly made safe decisions and didn't really take any risks, nor did it really change things up. The situation that we were already aware of at the end of Paranormal Activity 2 still remains true at the end of this movie. Nothing has changed. So that safe score is right down the middle at 50%. And because maybe I like the Kinect sensors, the Skype thing, all that, my bias score's slightly higher than that at 54%, averaging everything out to a final score of 52%, 52 out of 100 possible stars, or an F letter grade. It has failed. Yes-siree, Bob. Just as I expected it to. This is actually the first movie during my Interpreting the Scares event to get an F letter grade. But guys, let me know your thoughts on Paranormal Activity 4 in the comment section down below. While I think it's just getting worse and worse, do you actually think that the complex nature of these films actually makes them better? Let me know. As for YouTube, you guys know what to do. Hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed this review, because there's always more like it coming out each and every single day. Hit the subscribe button and bell to be notified when I come out with my review for Paranormal Activity, The Marked Ones. And until then, guys, peace out.
Dave examines movies. We just watch for fun. Davey is the expert. He is the number one critic that I go to when I need a movie pick. Thanks for joining up with us. We think you're pretty.